snuggle in, sweetie. It's cold out there.
What is this snowing, Grandma? Where does it come from?
Oh, that's a long story, sweetheart.
I want to hear.
Oh, not tonight. Go to sleep.
I'm not sleepy. Tell me, please.
Well, all right. I guess it would have to start with scissors.
Scissors?
Well, there are all kinds of scissors. And once there was even a man who had scissors for hands.
A man?
Yes.
Hands? Scissors?
No, scissor hands. You know the mansion on top of the mountain?
It's haunted.
Well, a long time ago, an inventor lived in that mansion. He made many things, I suppose.
Avon calling.
Weren't you just here?
No, not since last season. Today I've come to show you our exquisite new line of softer colors in shadows, blushes, and lipstick. Everything you need to accent and highlight your changing look.
My changing look. That's good.
Well, it goes without saying that I also have a complete selection of your old favorites, those tried and true products we've all come to depend on year in and year out.
Come on, Peg. I never buy anything from you. You know that.
I know.
Bye.
Bye, Helen.
You know, you didn't have to call me, ma'am. You could have taken care of this by yourself.
I could? I don't think so.
Yeah, you see, it's easy. Your food trap's clogged, that's all. You see this bulb here? You just unscrew this. Okay. And out she pops.
You know, on TV they say you repairmen are a lonely bunch of people. Housewives get lonely, too, although you may not realize it since they haven't made a commercial on the subject.
And then you just take this and put it back in here nice and easy. Be careful not to force it because it fits in there by itself. And then you just screw this back on.
Oh, now who could that be? Will you excuse me for a moment? Now, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. This is fascinating. I wouldn't want to miss a moment of it.
Good morning, Joyce. Avon calling.
Why, Peg? Have you gone blind? Can't you see there's a vehicle in my driveway?
Oh, yes.
Well, I'm surprised you don't realize that means I'm busy.
Okay, now we should decide on lipsticks. Okay, dear, what one did you like best? There was the Winsome Wahini, which looked charming on you, or the Bahimini Bliss.
I like them both.
Well, great.
You don't actually think I have any money, do you?
Just not my
fault.
come any closer. Just please. Those are your hands. Those are your hands. What happened to you? Where are your parents? Your mother? Your father?
He didn't wake up.
Are you alone? Do you live up here all by yourself? What happened to your face? I won't hurt you. But at the very least, let me give you a good astringent, and this will help to prevent infection. What's your name?
Edward.
Edward? I think you should just come home with me.
Yeah, it's Marge. Listen, I was standing outside and I was talking to Carol, and Peg drove by, and she had somebody with her in the car.
Did you get a good look at him?
No, I didn't get a good look at him. Did she say anything to you about having a guest or something?
She didn't say anything to me at all. She rang my doorbell at the crack of dawn this morning.
No. Okay, I'll meet you in the corner. Right. Bye. Isn't she?
freshen up and make yourself at home. Okay, that's the kitchen over there. You help yourself to anything you want to eat or drink. Those are grapes. And back here are the bedrooms. Let me get you some towels and I'll see what we can find for you to wear. You know what? I think I have some of Bill's old clothes in here. This is perfect. Here, these should just fit you. Don't be alarmed. That's just the phone. Now you can go in Kim's room and put these on, and I'll be right with you.
Thank you. change for you, right, Ed?
Edward, dear. I think he prefers Edward.
Sure, sure. So what are you even doing with yourself up there in that big old place? I bet the view must be spectacular, huh, Ed?
Edward.
Yes?
No, I just...
See all the way to the ocean, I bet, huh?
Sometimes.
Be darned. just wonderful, Ed. My God, you have the whole family in there, don't you?
Thank you. doctor friend of mine might be able to help you.
Hi, Micah.
Oh, Jack.
Hi, kids.
Hey, hi, George Monroe. Whoa, it's a heck of a handshake you got there, Ed.
Harry, I saw you on the golf course last week.
Yeah, I love Harry. We got about a dozen of the mail. We got a dozen of the mail.
Do you want something to eat? Okay. Are you hungry?
See you in a minute.
Yeah, you want a cracker?
Different.
Oh, completely different.
No kidding.
He's so mysterious. Do you imagine those hands are hot or cold? And just think what a single snip could do.
Or undo.
Eddie. Oh. The guys and I were talking. Now, we'd like to invite you to our card game Friday night. Would you like that? Only thing is, you can't cut.
I have my own infirmity. Never did me a bit of harm. Took some shrapnel during the war, and ever since then, I can't feel a thing. Not a damn thing. Listen, don't you ever let anybody tell you you have a handicap.
Who's handicapped? My goodness. Don't be ridiculous. You're not handicapped. You're, what do they call that? Exceptional. My name's Joyce, and I noticed that you have not tasted any of the ambrosia salad that I made especially for you.
Let's go. Lewis. You've been cloistered away up in that castle too long. You don't know anything about the wonderful world of teenage girls. They're all crazy. Here's some sweetened bad.
What is it?
Lemonade.
Can't eat that. He used his hands. I don't think it's sanitary.
See, I was hoping for something big and kind of bouffant, you know, kind of like mine. Now, don't you worry, kisses, you're going to be just fine, huh? You're going to be so pretty. Yes, you are.
Thank you. Good job. Look at that. You didn't break it or scratch it or anything. You'd be a pal and yelling pickles in, huh?
Quite a story, yes? Any questions, Grant?
Yeah. Get way over. Stand right up.
What's been the best part of your new life here in town?
The friends I've made.
Any other questions?
Or prosthetics? I know a doctor that might be able to help you.
I'd like to meet him.
We'll get that name after the show. Thank you very much. That's very nice. Anyone else? Yes, stand right up.
But if you had regular hands, you'd be like everyone else.
Yes, I know.
I think he'd like that.
But then no one would think you were special. You wouldn't be on TV or anything.
No matter what, Edward will always be special.
Thank you.
Velcro, sweetheart. It's Velcro and it hangs on the dashboard.
I've never seen this.
Sorry, I'm late.
Hi. Sorry, Jimmy. Just go get her without you. Here you go.
So, Edward, you have a productive day.
Mrs. Monroe showed me where the salon's going to be. You could have a cosmetics counter.
Oh, wouldn't that be great?
Great.
And then she showed me the back room where she took all of her clothes off.
Edward, I can't tell you how thrilled I am. I'm just as pleased as punch.
This whole beauty parlor venture is going to teach you volumes. Nothing like running your own business. I've never done it myself, but from what I gather, it's the greatest satisfaction of working making. So I guess the bank's going to be your next step, huh?
The bank?
Yeah, take out a loan, get yourself started.
Nothing to worry about. With your talent and reputation, it's going to be a snap. There is no collateral.
No, we already have a second on the house, but don't the testimonials make a difference? Did you see you're the mayor's wife? Can't wait to become a client.
We simply can't do it. Now, get yourself a social security card, establish credit, and buy yourself a car. You have a decided advantage. You can get one of those handicap placards, no problem, park anywhere you like.
This isn't the end of it. We'll get your money somehow. But that's breaking and entering.
Look, my parents have insurance up the rear, okay? Well, it cost them a little hassle, that's about it. A week and my dad will have a new and better everything.
We can't.
Look, there's a guy who'll give us cash for this stuff.
Jim, I don't want to.
Well, you don't want us to have our own van like Denny's when we can be by ourselves whenever we like?
Huh?
With a mattress in the back?
Well, why can't you just do it?
Because my father keeps the damn room locked. We need Edward to get us in.
Well, can't you take the key like when he's sleeping or something?
Look, you don't understand. The only thing he hangs on to tighter is his dick. Come on, Kim. Razor blades will do anything for you.
What do you mean? That's not true.
Oh, no? Why don't you ask him?
That's not fair.
What's fair got to do with it? There isn't any other way.
There's gotta be.
Look, I've racked my brain. Don't you want us to have our own van?
Yeah. Jim, the lights are on.
Those go automatically. They're gone for the weekend, I told you.
That's right. In case of burglars.
Yeah.
Turn off the alarm, right?
Yes, what do you think? Shh. Now, come on, let's go.
Look, I hate this. I can't believe this is happening. Are you sure he doesn't know this is Jim's house? He's never been here.
This person stole from...
Shh, shh. Keep your voice down. I told you he stole it, all right? Now, come on, let's go.
Tell his parents and they'll make him give it back.
Shh, shh. Listen, I already tried it. The guy's parents like he is, okay? Now, I told Kim you'd do this. Well, come on, let's go. Come on. Come on.
Sitting off the alarm in your house. We'll tell them we freaked and ran.
We're not going back there, okay?
We
my father would prosecute.
His own son?
Especially his own son. If Edward tells, I'll kill him.
Daddy, turn around.
No.
Turn around.
No.
Andrew.
We want your hands high in the air where we can see them.
Something in his hands. Looks like knives.
Drop your weapon! I repeat, drop your weapon! I'm gonna ask you one more time. This is your last warning. Drop your weapon. If you fail to do so, we'll have to open fire. Don't make us do that, buddy! Drop your weapon! Drop them! Now!
It's like we got a psycho. All right, cuff him.
We can see him now.
You can see him now. We're going to have to hold him overnight for observation.
He has to stay in prison all night.
You can pick him up in the morning.
Oh,
dear.
Oh, Edward. Hello, Edward. Oh, Edward, dear. I blame myself.
In God's name, what's going through your minds?
Why didn't I set a better example? I mean, you saw how I envied Jim's parents their money.
Then what were you going to do with that stuff once you had it?
Oh, I'd blithely say, oh, we'll get money for the salon somehow, but I never meant stealing. Dear, stealing's not the way to get it. Stealing's not the way to get anything.
Except trouble, and you're in a serious heap of that.
Oh, Edward, why ever did you do this? You know, damn those TV programs.
Damn them all to hell.
Or did somebody put you up to this?
Will he be okay, Doc?
The years spent in isolation have not equipped him with the tools necessary to judge right from wrong. He's had no context. He's been completely without guidance. Furthermore, his work, the garden sculptures, hairstyles, and so forth, indicate that he's a highly imaginative character. It seems clear that his awareness of what we call reality is radically underdeveloped.
But will he be all right out there?
Oh, yeah, he'll be fine.
Listen, it could keep me up all night worried about you. You watch yourself here.
Noise and Irina. I was
all alone. I felt in my gut there was something wrong with him.
He could have been my house.
Could have been any of our houses, but
I warned you, didn't I? I saw the sign of Satan on him. You didn't heed my warning, but now you will, because now you can see it too.
Must have been awful when they told you whose house it was.
why'd you do it?
Because you asked me to.
Otherwise, he'd still be in jail. What more do you want from me?
You could tell the truth.
So could you. You were there, too.
It wasn't my idea. You know I didn't want to do it.
But you did do it. I don't get why you give such a shit anyway. We're talking right and wrong.
Shut up.
Oh, goodness sake. No wonder poor Edward can't learn right from wrong living in this family.
Well, did you hear what he did to Peg's curtains? It's unbelievable that they're having their Christmas party anyway. Are you going?
Oh, I don't think so.
He practically raped Joyce, you know, threatening her with those knives of his. It's a miracle she escaped.
Oh, I don't have anything against Bill and Peg, but...
I know. They've got that teenage daughter in the house. Oh, those poor things. After what happened to me. Can you imagine?
What did you say to Peg about the Christmas party?
I said I hoped we could make it.
I lied, too.
Think we should be having this party?
Of course I think we should be having this.
this part? Of course I do. I mean, it's just what we need, just to calm things down and everything will just go back to normal. Hmm? We can have any more bells.
Here to sit in there with the hands.
Oh.
man with a scissor.
Well, thank God you're right here. You can do something about that.
All right, calm down, calm down. Go on home. We'll handle it. Just go home.
It's a little early for Christmas, Edward, but I have a present for you. Thank you.
like I'm gonna pass out or puke or something. Later. First, take me to her house.
Oh, come on, Jim. Don't make me drive.
Just do it.
Jesus. Maybe she was right about you.
Just drive!
Relax.
Thank you. Is he in there?
He's dead. The roof caved in on him. They killed each other. You can see for yourselves.
Never saw it.